massacre, you know, 148 to 114, I believe. Check on it. I'm pretty sure that was the score. And the next day, the narrative was it's going to be a blowout. Lakers came back up 8-2. Apparently, Pat Riley bit into them and challenged them. And it's just human nature. You know, when you get to this level of basketball, great teams in every round. Two teams going head to head. One team wins the first game. You better believe the second team, the team that lost, is going to be upset and bring more energy into the side. Human nature to let your guard down a little bit. The way it manifests itself with us is through turnover. And that's that was a big problem.
Excuse me? You're on your bench.
Well, I think one of the reasons it's more challenging is because of the way Houston plays. You know, they play so small and they spread you out. So it nullifies several guys who you ordinarily would be able to play. And then Patrick McCaw being out, that takes us down a wing. But this is the playoffs. You know, every series brings a different challenge. And different guys off the bench are going to have a chance to make an impact. And I got no problem with how we have to approach this with our bench, mixing and matching. It's all part of it.
Steve, every postseason for the last 7 years,
well, the first thing it takes is talent. The guy's so gifted. He's going to score more goals. But the second thing, what I've noticed with KD in the past 2 years, is it's a different level of focus and intensity from playoffs. And he's locked in the playoffs. He's locked in. He's competing. And he's locked in like that. Like most players, he plays better. It's been fantastic. Just stay locked in. You can see the focus. You can see the
level. No, no. In your 4 years here, how would you put it small?
I thought he was a good defender. The first year we were here, he was a good defender. He was an excellent defender in terms of playing passing lanes, using his quick hands, getting being disruptive, getting steals, that kind of stuff. It's a little different series just because of targeting and so much. We've seen it before. It's like, you know, Steph has said himself, that's the obvious thing to do. Because the other four guys are all 6'7", 6'8", long arms. So we're used to that. Steph's used to that. That's how the game is going to be played. We've got to adapt to
the game. But that was a decision side. Yeah.
I think that's an underrated dynamic to this. I think Steph's healthy. You know, he's moving fine, but this is more rhythm than anything. You come back from 6 weeks in the regular season, chances are you're going to have a game where nobody's focused, and you know, some other team's playing their fourth or five nights, and the defense isn't that tough, and you make a bunch of threes, and you just feel good. Playoffs, you know, the analogy I would use would be to baseball. Come back in the playoffs and you're facing the other team's best pitching night after night. World Series, playoff game. You're not going to get that one freebie where they have to, you know, call up the guy from the minors and he's much more hittable. So it's harder to adapt in the playoffs, but I feel really good about where Steph is and our ability to help him and help free him up. I want Steph shooting every time he's open. We got to do a little better job getting him. We will. Yeah, we've got some thoughts on that.
What about the routine?
Oh, no. Steph has the same routine every single day. Game day, off days. And reminds me of all the great shooters I've ever been with. Steve Nash, Reggie Miller, Mark Price. There's a routine, there's a standard routine that they go through that keeps them going through the ups and downs that they never know. I think it's a big help. You know, his conditioning is getting better and better. As we get further and further from the injury, he's going to be in better shape. He's going to have more.
He's coming back from injury. Not necessarily.
Depends who you're talking about.